Hello, Dan.
Hey, how are you?
Great. Much better than a sinner deserves. How about you, Dan?
I'm doing all right.
Great. How can Trent help you tonight? Why are you are you an atheist, agnostic? What's your deal?
I'm agnostic. I grew up in a Southern Baptist church. My dad's a preacher, actually.
Okay.
And I guess, really, I just don't understand why there's so many different sects of Christianity and why Catholicism is the right one. Because I believe there is a God out there, or gods or something, and I've experimented, mm-hmm. if you will, with other religions, Buddhism. I've read the Quran. I've read most of the Bible. I've checked other things out. Christianity still seems like it's what's right to me. I just don't quite
grasp. Dan, you look at all the divisions, all the multiplicity of denominations, and it seems one big chaotic soup. And if Jesus Christ was God, surely he would have arranged maybe one church and keep it simple?
Yeah, something okay. like that, yeah.
Sure. Trent, so it sounds, Trent, like if you make the case for Catholicism, Dan will no longer be an agnostic.
Yes, or hopefully we'll be moving away from that inclination. Dan, I think I would say that the diversity in religious belief can be attributed to many things. I wouldn't attribute it to God. I would attribute to people might obey or disobey God. They may trust in their own pride or their own reasoning and reject God's revelation. And that's essentially what happens with heresies. And I guess I would say this, that you and I seem to agree that Christianity makes sense. God became man, the man Jesus of Nazareth. He died on a cross and he rose from the dead. But as he promises us in the Gospel of John, I would say that Jesus didn't leave us as orphans. Not only did he leave us his spirit, but he built a church. Matthew chapter 16 describes this happening, and he says to the Apostle Peter, he changes Peter's name, and the guy's name was actually Simon, and he changes it to Peter, which comes from the Greek word Petros, which means rock. And he says, you're Peter, you're rock, and on this rock I will build my church. And what the Catholic Church teaches is that there's this unbroken chain of bishops and popes going back to that first century. And the other churches we see are branches that have come off, people who have disagreed with the church about theology and other things like that. But the church itself has maintained this unified belief for 2,000 years and has continued to spread God's word. And I think that there's many things that boast for the Catholic Church being the church Jesus started. And if this is the church Jesus started and Jesus promised it wouldn't fail, then I would believe him. So do you have any other thoughts on that or anything else I can try to help you with?
I mean, I guess that makes sense, but at the same line, if the Catholic Church is right in all their doctrine, because, growing up Southern Baptist and getting away from that, it is extraordinarily different because we don't pray to any saints. In fact, we don't really have any saints. There's no... Mm-hmm. There's no bishops, no popes, none of that. And I don't know. I understand the hierarchy, and it makes sense that there would be hierarchy. I just don't understand. Like, if you're a Baptist, are you going to hell because you're not a Catholic and you don't believe the same things? Or how would that work?
Well, Dan, I can envision 89,000 additional follow-up questions you could ask Trent about that. The salvation of non-Catholics is a very interesting one. We've covered it many times. Trent, what about starting with your book and then invite Dan and people listening to go to our website and do a keyword search? I mean, Catholicism is such a myriad of.
Yeah, Dan, I think that what you're saying is, what my church believes is different than the Catholic Church. Wouldn't you and I agree we should try to believe what Jesus and the first Christians, what they believed? Would that be a good goal?
Yeah, and that's why I'm swinging or curious, I guess, about the Catholic Church, because it is the first church.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, that is a good question you can ask. You can actually Google this question and see a neat chart about it. It's called Who Started Your Church? I believe John Salza actually came up with this, but other people have put together lists. You can see the different times in history in the 19th century and the 16th century. Different churches are started by Martin Luther or Calvin or John Smith or Joseph Smith, Mary Baker Eddy. But only the Catholic Church can say there's an unbroken chain that goes back to Jesus Christ himself, that has retained the valid authority for all the bishops, including the Bishop of Rome, who is the Pope. So if you want to, you can go to our website, catholic.com, and you can search for tracts, search for church fathers, and you can read what the very first Christians, people like Justin Martyr, St. Irenaeus, these are the first generations of Christians, what they believed. And you'll find, Dan, that they believed very closely to what they believe what Catholics today believe. They believe that the Eucharist is the real physical presence of Jesus Christ. They believe that baptism isn't a symbol. Baptism really regenerates and saves us from sin. They believed there should be priests and bishops, and one bishop is preeminent among them. That would be the Pope, the Bishop of Rome. So go to our website, Catholic.com, and just search for Church Fathers, First Christians. And yeah, just keep looking and feel free to call back. We'd enjoy hearing from you again.
Hope that's a help, Dan.
Thank you.
Congrats on your new book. And by the way, if you didn't know, this radio show is the outreach on the air of the Catholic Answers Apostolate. Our website is Catholic.com. And you'd be most welcome to chime in, do a keyword search, and call back whenever you want. Dan, we'll ship the book off as soon as we can.
All right, thank you.
All right, thanks, Dan.